listen to what you're doing for women and for people coming, people who are coming out incarcerated. That's those are issues that, you know, aren't touched on the mainstream because they're not palatable to be able to have ad space. You know, don't nobody want to spend ad space on child trafficking and human trafficking. Mm-hmm. Spend time on those topics because they're they're not those that are sexy to us, because it's not something you want to turn on the news after coming home from work to see about. But we who know that it's a real live issue for those who we can possibly help, we got to do that, brother. So later for the naysayers, stay on your path and keep that cooking going. I saw that, man. But you know something, brother? You know who we need right now, man, that would be interesting to see what his position would be Kobe Bryant.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? To see where he would fall and what his leader, what, you know, like what I tell people is oftentimes we talk that leadership stuff. And for me, leadership is organic. It's something that pops up. And at this point in time, you're taking a leadership position, but you're not the leader. And that's what's happened to our people is that we've been told who our leaders were. And during the COINTELPRO program with J. Edgar Hoover, they were able to isolate individuals who were so important to the mass movement of our folks and assassinate them. And then we have this whole gang issue that actually came out of a movement that was about the people, man. And it wasn't any individual. And I think that's the thing that they're trying to do to you.
Yeah, we play into their playbook. I see people trying to say that he's a messiah. He's our leader. I'm no leader. Yeah. I'm still your
You know, brother, I'm so glad that you put that point up because it's a messianic brotherhood and sisterhood, man.
Yeah.
And we are. It's a unified body of Christ, and no one individual at one point in time, you may need to be the eyes and I'll be the little finger or whatever. Yeah. It's one of those things where we know that our lives are important and don't nobody have to put a hashtag in front of that for you to raise your children in that mindset, me to raise my children in that mindset. No one has to tell my son or my baby boy that their life matters because they realize it from
we tell them.
Absolutely. And I think the biggest part is they see it when you're doing your research and your son or daughter may walk into the room and see you researching and then they back off because daddy is on something and they can see it in your eyes that it means something to you. And then when they stop and ask you what it is you doing, then you can start to see in their eyes a different mentality of how they see the world, as opposed to just saying, man, my daddy was a million. My daddy's a millionaire, played in the league and did it. But now they see in the reality of what your mission is on the planet, not just, you know, and I tell people that basketball, for many of us, that was our ability to go in and use it as a minefield, that we go in and mine whatever economics we could bring back to our community and to our family.
And but, then, but you know what, not to cut you off, they shun us when we do that. You know, when we make it, that I'm hearing a lot of things that he's a part of the system because he made it. He's a part of the system because he's no longer with us. If that's the weak mindset that you have, that we can't make it, go learn, get the knowledge, the wealth, and come back and bring you up. Isn't that what we're supposed to do? I think a lot of guys that are not builders, that are not doing anything, they're the ones that's holding these guys back that are going out and have the work to prove what they're doing. They have the talk. So what there do you go. About that?
And like you say, they have that platform. They have that platform to be able to show that, oh, you don't have to go that route. You don't have to go that route as Kwame. And then one of the things that I found this interesting when I wrote my book, Dave Zirin, who's a national, you know, media guy, he came forward for my book and he said when he went around the league and asked players why they weren't socially active and stuff, many of them said, you remember what happened to Craig Hodges, which was wild to me. That, you know, a lot of young players had studied to history, even to the point where I'm sure some agents have told players to make sure that you stay away from the politics of it. Let's work on nothing but your branding and seeing how many fans and how many jerseys you can sell. But as opposed to, you know, the reality, you know, you stop and you think about, I heard you and Devin talking about how you have to have so many appearances for the team every year. And so many people don't realize how much impact that has for the larger community, whether you're going to an automobile dealer or whether you're going to a florist. You know, you are impacting economics on a different level for ownership. But when asked on that same level to give back to the community, to where, like right now, every team in professional sports across America should be contributing to STEM education, to the stuff that you're working on, to sustainable housing. And, you know, it's a myriad of things that when I was listening to you and Devin, it was inspiring to the point to hear how brothers have come together and realize that we have a working cooperative opportunity that was never exploited before. And now we have both the technology to be able to do it, where I don't have to be in Georgia, I don't have to be in Minnesota, I don't have to be in LA, but we can make sure that we keep the vibration moving in the right direction. And we as athletes know that momentum is everything. So the momentum that you have going right now, you couldn't pay for it, brother. And tell people it's so much larger than you. So just around my circle, the amount of intensive electricity that's going on around Brother Brown is cool to me, because, you know, I tell people, I had a chance to play with MJ. I had a chance to, you know, work with Kobe. So I've had the basketball world, and you know how the conversations we used to have. Everybody, you know, that's the wild part of this whole thing when I'm listening to it, is everybody that's been in professional sports has had this conversation that you're bringing up, whether it's on the bus, whether it's in the locker room. You know, we've had these conversations, but how many times won't nobody step up in front of the camera and do like Kyrie is doing?